Welcome to another Blender tutorial series. In celebration of Serpens hitting its 1 year mark, I figured I would cover a couple of introductory videos following along with the Darkfall series. Darkfall is a YouTuber who teaches people how to use Python to script in add-ons in Blender. And what better way to learn visual scripting than to follow along with his tutorials in the visual scripting workspace so I can teach you how to set up the same structure that Darkfall teaches you in Python, and you can see both sides and learn both ways. Now, visual scripting, in my opinion, for this tutorial series will get you to the same result in a fraction of the time. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, if you don't know how to install Serpens, I have a video for that in the description, along with the first Darkfall video that we're going to be following along with. And once you've installed Serpens, you want to make sure that you can check the show full errors, showing the Python file. And if you want, keep the file after the error. When you do have errors, you can come up to Window and toggle the system console. Or you can download on the add-ons page under the add-on creation template. I've got a couple of buttons that are set up that can help you toggle the console and clear it as well. So if you don't already have a scripting workspace set up, you can click on Add Workspace, go to General, and under Scripting, you can click. And we're not going to be using the text editor, so we can change this to the visual scripting editor instead. If you don't have an add-on already, you can click on New and go ahead and name it Add Object Script and click OK. And now you've got your main graph set up in the Serpens End panel, and we can go ahead and register our panel class. Shift A and go to Interface and click on Panel. It's the second item from the top. Call this Test Panel, New Tab. Now when you click on your eyedropper, it's going to change the category name. I just wanted to show that. The eyedropper lets you pick anywhere you want to place a panel, but we're going to follow along with Darkfall, and in the 3D viewport, look for the select panel and then click it, and it'll set it up for the 3D viewport UI. Give your category name and label, and then Shift R will compile, or you can click on the compile button. And now we've got our panel. Next is to make a label, so Shift A, interface, and about halfway down we have a label node. You're going to connect all of your interface nodes with the diamond that's colored yellow. And each one of these panel lines is going to be a line on our panel itself. Give your line a name, and then compile, and you'll notice that it's there. So if I duplicated this and went to the next line, you'd see that it's another line down. Now I can add in a row as well, so Shift A. And Darkfall has done a couple of rows in some of his script. You don't necessarily need to do that in this structure, because every line off of the panel is going to make you a new line. But we do want two elements coming off and splitting a line for our buttons. So add in a row node, and then Shift A, and we'll add in a button as well. It's about a third of the way down from the top. And the button's going to have an icon, so Shift A, and under Input, towards the bottom, there's the icon node. Now Darkfall adds an icon as well for the label, and these are both going to be a cube. Compile now. Now we don't have the button tied to anything, so let's go ahead and do that. Now, currently, there are no Serpens operators, so this is going to be a blank menu. And we can click on the Serpens icon and change it to be a Blender icon. And we can go and copy an operator. Now, you can create an operation by adding in a cube, or you can come into the Add menu, and under Mesh, you can right-click on the cube and click on Copy Operator. This won't actually cause the operation to happen, so it's kind of nice because you don't have to go in and delete things that you've added. And we can paste it right there. Now the same thing would work if I added the cube in. I could either do a Shift A, but you can't copy out of floating menus, but you can cause the operator to happen still. So notice how it shows up in the info panel. And I could hit Control C to copy that and paste it the same. Now you can define your own custom location, rotation, and scale if you'd like, or you can blank these all out and it will just do this default add cube. Let's compile, and you notice we have the button now. So we need to duplicate this setup Shift D to duplicate after we select both those nodes. Just remember when you're copying that you want to customize your text. So we want to add a sphere now. We'll clear out the operator. We'll change the icon to a sphere. And we need to go into the add menu and copy the operator. So I'm going to do the same thing and clear these out because we'll just use the default settings. And compile again with Shift R. Now you notice there's a small gap, even though we're on the same row. If you want to close that gap, it's easy enough just to click on the align checkbox. And now they're hugging together. And on my 3D cursor, let's move it over here and add a cube. Move over here and add a sphere. So we've got that functionality. Now he has another line where he's going to add in a font. So Shift A. Let's duplicate these. And we're going to do a new line. And he's calling this font button. Come in and search for font. And we need to clear out our copied operator and copy in a text. We'll clear these out for the default settings. And Shift R to compile. And now we've got the structure that Darkfall built in a fraction of the time. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you. The video ended not really teaching you how to make it into an add-on, but I'm going to go ahead and do one step further from his video, and we're ready to make this into an add-on. So if you click on the add-on section in the Serpens End panel, all you got to do is click on Save Add-on. Go ahead and save it to wherever you want, and it will batch it up into a zip file, and it'll be ready for you to install when you install it just like any other add-on. And it's as easy as that. I hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll catch you on the next one.